Wait a minute, I have to be on my good side. Let me see, I'm gonna sit here. I'm gonna, you know, you go through all these things. We don't make it simple. Love is simple. It's so stupid. We go through this junk. But think about it back when you were a teenager. You know, oh, you couldn't move. You couldn't move your arm because your strap would fall down. You didn't want that yet. You know what I mean? Please, yet? Oh, God. And then when the passion rose, oh, forget that. It was gone anyway, you know what I'm saying? I mean, come on, get real. We're just getting real. Getting real with God's doing our lives as real people. You know, you can't make it hard. It's simple. It's a simple, glorious gospel of love. And God is so good. Verse 11, beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. You know what? I got the audacity to look at somebody and say, well, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And meanwhile, you know what? It was 20 years ago. I was doing the same thing. Wait a second. Now we've gone brain dead. We think like we've been saved all the time. And we're so up in the spirit now that, you know, we can point fingers and say, but I would have done that. But, and I was there at work and I said, they were saying one thing and this and one other thing. And I said, you know what? We are all ridiculous in here. None of us have done any better or any worse than anybody else. And we don't have any right to point any fingers at anybody. So what are we going to do? They all turned and walked away. I said, I'm going to repent. Kev says, I am too. You know what I'm saying? We're correcting ourselves. In just a little setting, we're realizing, you know, wait, we can't condemn somebody. It's about stupid. But see, what it is it does get so far removed from us. We have forgotten it. Thank God we've forgotten it. We were laying it aside. It's not a heavy weight anymore. But you know what? There's still people with these heavy weights on them. And they need to be captured. They need to be captured and released from captivity through the praise, through the worship, through whatever He has for you to do, when He has for you to do it. You know, a lot of times, I mean, I've traveled so much up and down the roads, going here, going there, and just like Jay, he'd say, Mom, all you would do is pray in the Holy Ghost. How could we even talk? I said, because you know what? I'm a woman on a mission. And I don't know what to do, I don't know what I'm going to meet up with, and I don't know where I'm going. But I tell you, but I did know the destiny, but I didn't know about the placement, I didn't know who was going to be the, how he's going to do it, but I knew that I would pray in the Holy Ghost, that the Holy Ghost would lead me and guide me in all truth, and I'd be set up for success, and that other people would be too. Despite my feelings and thoughts about the whole thing, I was going to make sure that I was going to set them up for success, and that's what God has always done and used me for, setting somebody else up for that success, because I know it's capable in your life to have. It's capable, and you are well able to take the land around you, and you can possess that land in this success. Beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. Your soul is that soulish room that you don't want nobody to tamper with. But guess what? He says, through the prosperity, for you to prosper, that realm has got to be touched. That realm has got to be fixed, and it has to be talked about. If you don't want to talk about anybody else, and believe me, you really can't trust anybody anymore, because they don't know what to do with it either. Because if they never went through something, they don't have a clue about the drama and the shock you had. So in that, the crust of the wave, speak to God about it. 100% tell Him. It's no secret. And it's no secret what God can do. What He's done for others, He can do it for you. And He's got to do it. Because when you get desperate enough, He will do it. You know why? Because it's time for it to be done. A woman, when she starts to feel the pains, she knows she better get to the hospital because that baby's coming out. We don't live back when the Indians had them out in the weeds. No. So, you know what? When people start realizing they've got to have God, they've got to be fixed, they've got to be healed, they've got to be saved, they're going to come running to this hospital. And that's going to be the building where God has prepared, not this one, for us to be able to house the people to get healed, saved, and delivered. I know it's coming, and it's here right now. And God will perform His word with signs following, because He always does. We are about to embark on the greatest revival that's ever been and that will ever be. And that's what the word says. And by us being prepared, us being healed, being willing to start with new beginnings, being willing to start small and have God work in us that tremendous work that He's done, bringing things up, old case files, healing, saving, setting free, even in the night hours. The angels have been ministering to us in the night hours when we're sleeping. And we didn't know what's going on. And we come up a different way. Oh, you might have still had a little crick and you might have still had a little pain. But you know, before you know it, it's gone. You know, you could vodeo do again. You could be renewed in the youth, in your old age. You know what I'm saying? Because God said it will be possible. And people need to see it. They need to see where you've had this. And they need to see how you had that. They need the testimony, because Jesus is testimony, and that is prophecy. And we prophesy to you tonight that God is good to you too. He's allowing you to breathe. He's allowing you to live. And He's allowing you right now to accept Him for who He is, and that is your God. He's the only God that ever will be and ever was and who ever will shall be. And so if you're going back to Him because He created you, then you just as well to get to know Him right now. Because when you stand face to face to Him, you can say, Daddy God, I'm glad that you're here and I'm here. And this is a place where I always want to be. We don't know what we're going to say, what we're going to do. We're all going to have different expressions. You know, I say now, oh, I want to run and I want to run to Jesus' feet and I'm going to kiss Him. I don't know what I'm going to do, because you know what? In the glory, no crying, no dying, no sorrow, no pain. Oh, come on. Just sometimes we get in the high glory in here. What do we think about? Oh, no, we're in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, and we're surrounded by the heavenlies. We're in that place we always want to stay, and we're going to stay. The only reason why we're here is to bring in the harvest. Bring in the harvest, and those are souls. We're going to bring in everything. All of our fruits and labors are remaining. We're going to say, you know what, I come in, but guess what? Boom, giddy, boom. Here's the other millions that you assigned to me. And that's what He wants to do with you. You've got souls to win. You've got to stay alive. The only person that keeps you alive is Jesus Christ and Him crucified, resurrected in a body. And right now, your body can be resurrected too. You can receive salvation. You can receive the healing right now. If you say, Jesus, come into my life. I want to be saved. I want to be healed. And the hitch that get along is, nevertheless, not my will, but thou will be done. Give Him your life right then. If you'll just give Him the whole thing, He'll fix the whole. He'll fix the whole, make you whole. And He'll make you free like you always want to be. And we'll be seeing you soon. Thank you. We'll be seeing you soon.